shots going in for you? I mean, were you planning to take the ball? I mean, what were you looking for? And kind of, was it nice to see those shots go in and do well?
You know, it's always great to see shots go in. So, you know, that's always a plus. And, you know, I was just trying to make a play, see, you know, how our team win. And that's what happened.
You said yesterday you'd like to be more of a factor, especially getting to the rim. Were those last kind of 8 minutes really what you envisioned when you said that?
Well, I just want to stay on attack mode. I saw the other point guard on the team, DeAndre, you know, doing a good job getting downhill, so I figured I can do the same. So I just started attacking the rim, trying to make plays, and finishing at the basket.
Brian, Andy was talking about how hard it is for a team to kind of maintain energy when you're not making shots. You guys obviously weren't making a lot of shots. How did you guys maintain energy? What were you guys saying amongst each other, you know, down 9 points with 9-10 minutes to go?
Well, you know, we're a defensive team. We pride ourselves in, you know, locking up. We work on it all the time in practice. And, you know, shots don't fall. We're just going to pick it up on the defensive end and try and get in the transition. So, you know, we just stayed energetic, stayed positive, and stayed the course, and we got a big win.
Andy obviously looks at you to be a leader, being the point guard and everything. How much easier is it to be a leader when you make big shots and you know, and do things like that to help the team win?
Well, definitely Coach Kennedy, you know, comes to me to be the leader of this team. I am the point guard, and I do need to step up and be a little bit more of a vocal leader. And day by day, I'll try and, you know, better myself in that. But, you know, making those two shots is a major confidence boost for me. You know, going into the next game against Auburn, I'm going to look to do the same thing.
Brian, what do you guys say to Terrence to help him through this stretch right now?
Yeah, we're with him. We love you. You know, keep shooting, and you know you're going to get out of this one.
What do you think this team is capable of? What's your potential?
The sky's the limit. You know, that's the potential of this. I don't think anybody on our schedule that we have coming up is just a guaranteed loss. I think we can beat everybody that we have coming up.
Great, when you went to the 1-3-1 zone and you got a couple of stops, did you feel the energy of your team rise?
Definitely. 1-3-1, you know, was hurting them a little bit. They were struggling. And, you know, the crowd was into it. It was just a great atmosphere.
Free, I saw you and Lamar Peters discussing things throughout the game at time and everything. I mean, how much of a rivalry is that? You know what I mean? Like, what's that like on the court?
Well, you know, he's always been, you know, projected ahead of me. You know, last year I wasn't all freshman team. And, you know, guys like that, you know, he gets all the recognition. I'm going for the next. So, you know, that's, it was just competitive basketball, and that's the name of the game.
This is two strong games for you now. Just what's been different in the past couple of games?
Just my approach to the game. You know, day before the game, I'm taking practice really serious. You know, not joking around, shoot around the day before the game. Everything's business. So, you know, and it's rubbing off on the rest of my teammates, and I think you'll start to see that down the road.
This is also back-to-back impressive games for you against Mississippi State. Just what is it about this team?
I mean, you know, it's our rivalry. I go to Ole Miss, and I know, you know, you could lose every game, but if you beat Mississippi State, it's almost a good season. So, you know, every game we play Mississippi State, it's almost, you know, my time to defend, you know, Ole Miss and the school I go to.
All right. Thanks, Brian.